Panarin scores! Panarin, fire scores!
The thing that really jumps out at me is how much he loves hockey. This guy works hard at his craft. It's no mystery he's turned himself into an elite player in the National Hockey League. I think he's ready to embrace what's ahead of him. He doesn't seem to have a bad day. He's a great guy to talk to, great guy to be around. He's got an infectious personality, and when you add that to his on-ice ability, we think we got a pretty special player.
Jacob Trouba seems to be that kind of a guy, too. When you, in your mind, start to slate his role, does he automatically become a 25-minute eating, play every single role possible defenseman for you?
I mean, with his track record and the success he's had in this league, I think we'd be crazy not to put him in that position, but he's earned that position. You know, he's earned that opportunity. And, you know, he had a great year last year, and he continues to progress. He's only 25 years old, and that's the thing I think people have to keep in mind. I mean, we added some key pieces over the summer that are here for the long haul. This isn't quick fixes. And I think sometimes when you make a trade for someone like Jacob Trouba or a trade for someone like Panarin, people may draw the wrong conclusion, but this is really part of the plan, the master plan. It's something that we talked about a year and a half ago when we sent a letter out to our fan base of what we're trying to accomplish. And adding pieces like this was part of the plan all along.
We saw Mika Zibanejad take that next step in his hockey career and elevate his game. As he enters this season, how much will you rely on him to provide leadership for the myriad young players on your squad?
He checks an awful lot of boxes, almost all the boxes that you want in a first-line center. Obviously, he had a career year from a statistical standpoint, but boy, there was an awful lot else that he did for our organization other than put up points. He's the obvious name when people talk about us naming a captain. That being said, that's something that is... You need to put a lot of time and effort into going through that choice. You want to make sure you make the right choice. He certainly checks, again, a lot of boxes that you're looking for in your captain. And that's something that we've certainly talked about, but that'll take care of itself.
How will you handle Henrik Lundqvist, Alex Georgiev, and the whole goaltending situation?
The league in general has kind of gone to more of a two-goalie system. And you look at some of the guys that had success last year and some of their better years in the league, their numbers were down from a games played standpoint. And, you know, the last 2 years, Hank has had great first halves and maybe a little bit dipped the second half. And one of the things we've talked about is I want him to have a great season. I don't want him to have a great first half. And we're going to do everything we can to put him in that position. He's still an elite goalie. We're incredibly fortunate to have him. I mean, you talk about a true professional. Away from the rink as well. He takes great care of himself. He's highly competitive, and he really gives us an awful lot, not only in the net, but away from the rink.